Brittany, who just sang their song Shout Out. Can you give them another applause, please? So I have a few questions for you, if that's okay. What inspired your song Shout Out?
So I wrote the song Shout Out, and I wrote it because one of mine and Rachel's friends sadly took her own life a few years ago. So that's why that song.
Okay. Why did you? Oh, you've already said that. Sorry. It's a joint answer. What did you want to achieve with this song?
So after I wrote the song, I sort of wrote it like for myself because I always write about things that like happen to me or like people around me. But after that, after I started singing it with my sister, I decided that we should like try and make something like good out of something really, really bad that had happened. So we decided to, our way of doing this was to like release it as a single. And we released it, and all the money from the single went to a charity called Young Minds. And ever since then, we've been doing like charity work and gigs to raise money and awareness. So.
Well, you just answered more of the questions.
Yeah, I just realised that.
It's okay. Is there anyone in the audience who has questions for Rachel and Brittany? I can't really see, so. Thank you very much. Anybody? No? No takers? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome again to Reclaim the Future. Thanks a lot for joining us tonight. Reclaim the Future is a young youth-led event organised by Kate Paisley with participation with Rachel and Brittany, David McAdam, Corbin Neil Miles Jr., Sophie Patterson, Jump Dance Class, Renfrewshire Youth Commissioners and LADS. LADS is awesome. An acting group. This event is part of the Scottish Mental Health Arts Festival, and we are here to show how important art can be for mental health. I'm going to tell you a bit about Kate Paisley. Kate Paisley is a safe space for young people with artistic abilities to come along and feel free to really perform, draw, spoken word, and we've got some things on for Kate. If you want any more information, go to Mania. And he goes over here, by the way. So we do Kate Cafe. I don't know if anybody knows about that. Oh, you probably do, actually. Sorry. We're doing one, and it's a fundraiser for on the 20th for mental health. And I should have read this earlier. Sorry. And another thing is You Matter Always is... leaflets here, because I don't know much, sorry.
You can say when it is.
It's 20th of October, if you want to come along. Now we're going to listen to some spoken poets. Please applause for Corbin Neil Miles Jr.
Hello, I'm Corbin Miles Jr. Corbin Neil Miles Jr., as Cassia loves to point out since she knows my full name. I'm just going to share a bit of spoken word with you guys. I've been through 3 weeks of manic depression, stuck in a place of desperation, wondering when will it end, hoping it ends. Sometimes when you're stuck in depression, you just assume, oh yeah, you know, it'll never get better, but then you look at your friends, your family, and you know it has to get better. There's nothing you can do about it. There's no bones about it. There's no heart, no soul about it. You just have to get better. It's an overriding emotion. It's an overriding feeling. And nobody will understand it except for you. But then somebody else understands. And you don't understand what they understand until you understand that they've been through it. And going through depression, even in that 3 weeks, you have no motivation, you're still stuck in that place of desperation, and all you want to do is just stop but you know you can't, because it's overriding that desperation, that survival instinct, that guiding light, that person who's been through it, that's the heart that people need to have when they go through things that maybe they don't understand, is that you're not alone. Somebody else has gone through it before, somebody will go through it again, but that's it. Depression is easy to beat, not in your head, but on your feet. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Corbin. And up now is Sophie Patterson, sorry.
Hi, I'm Sophie Patterson, and I have literally just read this about like in the last week, so I'm really nervous. I spent too much time at war with myself, and I need a break from my own thoughts. The thoughts that don't let me sleep at night, because they're creating demons that make my brain rot. I hear a squeak, and the demons tell me there's someone in your house, but it's just probably the squeak of a door or a field mouse. This is where my head goes, straight to worst case scenario, and it keeps me up the whole flipping night. But please believe me when I have tried to push them away, even put up a fight. Now I ask, how do you run away from your own thoughts when you can't control them because they control you? Also, what can the demons of anxiety do? Anxiety attacks are the absolute worst, but so misunderstood. So let me tell you what happens to your mood. You feel like you're suffocating and trapped in a small dark room, then a cold sweat comes along and you start to feel faint and your brain starts to swirl towards great doom. I finally look in the mirror and I see big black bags under my eyes. So what do? Cover them with makeup to no one's surprise. Foundation after foundation, powder after powder, so I look fake, and sometimes I have to add a smile to this cake. I add a smile because sometimes anxiety is like a buy one get one free deal. With anxiety comes depression, and with both, the worst you feel. Sometimes I can't even walk up the street without looking at someone thinking, are they laughing at me? Why is that? And your mind starts racing, like, is my hair weird? Do I look odd? Am I fat? I have started to compare myself to every other girl I see, and yet I lose every shot. Then I wonder to myself, why are they so pretty and I look like an actual top? And I have to admit, I'm jealous. And yes, everything I have said is I have experienced is true. But I'm now better and standing right here in front of you, saying I believe in you. Please don't let your mind bully you each and every day. And it's okay to say that all you did was live today. We need people to stand up and speak out about mental illnesses. Stop thinking you're weird or a freak. Let's just take a moment and look at everyone so here. So kind, so strong, and so unique. We haven't got a name tag around our neck saying, hi, I'm, and these are my mental illnesses. It's silent. No one knows you have it but you. Mental illness used to be a part of my life, and it still kind of is. But I don't believe I have anything to be ashamed of, and anyone who believes otherwise is the one to.
Thank you both. Now we're going to ask you some questions, if that's okay. So Sophie, if you want to come back then.
It's okay. So, what inspires you?
A lot of what inspires me is just stuff that, like, it's just stuff that comes into my head that I want to say to people, because a lot of people, especially like people with mental illness and stuff, feel like they can't say a lot, and doing spoken words, singing, that sort of thing actually is really great for just putting out what we feel like we can't actually say.
Yeah, mine was kind of the same thing, I agree. I just want more people to speak up about mental illness because it's taking too many people's lives, and just get the word out there that you shouldn't be afraid to speak up.
What was more difficult, to write the poem or to say it in front of everyone?
say it in front of everyone. Honestly, it's kind of petrifying when you go up, but after it's done, you feel way better and stuff like that. But at first, I'm sitting saying to my friend Greg, I can't do this, I'm going to die. No, I can't do this.
You did good, Sophie. I'm just gonna throw that out there. But as well, for me, it was actually hard to do both. A, because the spoken word I gave, when I do spoken word, I just talk. I don't memorize anything or anything like that. So literally, it was all off the cuff. And it is hard to deliver, because when you're saying something, you want to say what's in your heart, but you also want to be careful as well what you're saying, because the thing that's in your heart might not translate as well out into what else is going on. And it's knowing when to stop as well, because you could just go forever. Definitely. Writing and performing, it's like I was saying before, it's being able to speak and say what you can't say normally in normal conversation with somebody.
I like the writing part as well, because it like gets everything out of my brain that's in it, and my brain's just, if anyone could mind read, they'd scream and run away. Because it's always something weird going up there, so it's good to just get everything done on a piece of paper and stuff like that.
Is there anyone in the audience again wanting to ask our artists any questions?
Thank you.
Now we've got some more music. David McAdam.
So the song title is called Shine a Light, and I wrote it as part of one of Crate's films that he did about a year and a half ago. It's called Emergence. That will be shown at the end of this, or at the end of this event. So enjoy.
Set things right.
for you, if that's okay, David. What inspires Shine a Light?
Well, it was Emergence, and I took the kind of the basis of the whole film, and that's just kind of like, you know, it's good to have someone there that has your back, regardless of, you know, what you're going through. I've had a few friends that have suffered from mental illness, small or big. You know, I think everyone has in some degree, and it's always good to have someone that you can just talk to about it, and that's what inspired it.
Other than the short film, Emergence, what else would you want to achieve with this song?
I think it's just connecting with people, to be honest. I mean, like, people have came up to me and says, you know, that's a good song, you know, and they've shared with me their stories. And to be honest, the more people that I can connect with through my songwriting, the better. And yeah, I think that's really what I want to achieve with this song.
How does music make you feel? Do you feel like it's good to keep you happy and motivated?
Definitely. It's what I do. I mean, like, whether like I'm like sad, you know, or I just want to like bang my head against the wall because I had a rubbish day, or I'm like really, really happy, I just use music, to be honest. And whatever comes out of it, comes out of it. And without it, I don't know where I'd be.
Yeah. Is there anyone in the audience that has questions for David? Okay. So we're just going to continue on. If you have a seat, another applause for David. Okay. So our next performance should be the dance group, but they've only just arrived. So we're going to just move it on to the youth commissioners. Is that okay? Oh, never mind, they're here. apologies for that. So I'll just read off my screen now. Our next act is Jump Dance Studio with Lauren Bryce to introduce the group and tell us a bit more about the performance and what we're about to see.
My name's Lauren Bryce and I'm here from Jump Dance Crew in Paisley. We're just up the road on New Street. I'm here with some amazing young dancers who've been exploring together different themes of mental health and how that can affect your life and different ways of going through it and how you can make life better and different sort of approaches. So we've called the piece Talk, and it's about how using the community around you and talking to people is a very good way to make yourself stronger on your own with the support of people behind you. And that is everything, if that's all right with you.
Yeah.
So I hope you enjoy the piece.
Any questions? think I'm actually like the oldest in the group. I'm 15 this year, and doing I'm actually going like to about to do my exams. So part of what I'm doing, I'll be doing PE, but dancing I think has really helped me like focus on more not just things that are like creative like dancing, like sea games, like netball and volleyball. It's really helped me like kind of work in a team and get used to like having to like share an environment with other people. And I think doing like solo work and dancing, that's basically helped me like my whole like school life. And well, working with everyone else, that just helps you in like all your other classes, and that helps you know what it's like to be in an like, environment where you have to share it with other people. So yeah, I think dancing, I've definitely been set up with what I need for to either get like a dancing career or get any career really by like being part of this. So
and we're part of the youth commission. So the youth commission came around because we had a youth assembly, which some of you might have been there for. Yeah. And so at the youth assembly, it was decided that young people thought that mental health would be the biggest concern for people mainly. And so we drew a range of organisations and people that help us. And it helps us to be actively involved, to advocate change in community and for young people.
So the Youth Commission is supported by the Youth Commission Partners Group, who are made up of like youth agencies and organisations that support young people. And these include the Youth Services, the NHS Health Improvement Team, CREATE, Active Communities, Renfrewshire Carers, Street League, Who Cares Scotland, RAMH, Police Scotland, Acumen Network, Young Scot and Renfrewshire Youth Voice.
So the Youth Commission has been meeting regularly, and we're learning more about mental health, but we're also investigating resources and services that are available for other young people and the community. And to help us with this, we've been participating in training to help us use these skills and finding existing resources, and to design a campaign that raises awareness for mental health. And we're also exploring new ways to engage other people, other young people in the community, and the wider community.
So currently, we're planning events to tie in with Scottish Mental Health Arts and Film Festival, including a youth consultation event, which will explore how arts and culture impact positively on like, the well-being of young people, and this will help contribute to Paisley 2021, which is for City of Culture. So we're setting up a social media campaign, which will start on Monday, and to follow that, it's hashtag Follow Your Feet, which you can find on Twitter as of Monday. And this will ask young people and the wider community to show how active they are in promoting their own and other people's positive well-being. So with this, the Youth Commission's also got Young Scot helping them out, and through them we're like negotiating a trailer to be able to get out in Paisley and speak to the youth.
You also get Young Scot reward points in
So if you want incentive to go.
I know Young Scot reward points out of it. Youth Commissioners are also working with partners to organise a community-based event during October and December, which will kind of be like another youth assembly, and that will continue to gather insight and experiences from the young people, which we will put towards our Youth Commission Symposium, which is basically us inviting about 50 local professionals, including Mary Black, and this will allow them to tell us what they're doing for young people with mental health disorders in Renfrewshire,
and will also let us challenge them. So what they're maybe not doing so great in Yorkshire and how they could be better. And everything that we gather and everything that we do in the symposium will be taken back to our youth assembly in 2018, which will be, as you can call, to change in the young people.
So on a separate note from the symposium, we've also got a few activities during the October week if you're free. So first there's a wellbeing walk, which will run on the Monday, the Wednesday and the Friday from 1 to 3pm. And that starts at Paisley Town Hall, but I think that's recently changed to Paisley Abbey. And that will just kind of go around Paisley and explore the history of it. And as well as that, there'll be the Young Scot trailer, which we previously mentioned, which will be there from Monday to Friday. And so if you're a young person, it's a good place to go to give your views, complete surveys, earn Young Scot reward points. Key point here. And it allows you to leave questions for us to ask at the symposium. So that means it's not just us contributing to it, it's the wider community. And we've got some flyers, which you can get from Lizzie. And I recommend picking them up because it has information about our Snapchat and Twitter accounts.
Yeah, and if you're wanting to like keep up with what we're doing, you can follow us on Twitter. It's hashtag RenUCommiss.
So I have a few questions for you. What do you have to do to be a part of the Youth Commissioners?
To be a part of the Youth Commissioners,
just come along.
It's basically just come along. So we're looking for young people. So currently it's about 15 to 25 is what we're looking for. We think some of the topics are quite adult for some of the young people, but we do still think it's important to include them if they feel up to it. So we regularly meet on Wednesdays at primary school,
at
about 4, so it's good after schools, and you just kind of come along and
give your opinions.
Okay, last question. Why did you get involved and how is this helping you?
So me and Jack got involved because we started an LGBT group in our school, under the umbrella of the high school. And so we were approached by Nicky Mills, who was our school's youth worker, and she asked us if we'd like to be involved with this commission that was involved with mental health, and we thought it might be good for us to get our opinions on the LGBT community involving mental health. So that's how we got involved.
Yeah, that's also quite important because we all have like our individual reasons for wanting to go. So in our friend group, a lot of people have mental health problems, so this is a good way for us to express our thoughts about how that's been dealt with, and whether it's been dealt with properly or not, because we have some first-hand experience.
Now, is there anyone in the audience who has questions for the youth commissioners?
Can I just say, if any young person, or you know of any young person that's interested, the trailer will be open every day next week, so if you want to come down, there'll be more information on the Youth Commission and also what Youth Services does, along with some of our other partners. And if you want to come down, and we're doing a survey as well for young people to fill out about how their experience in mental health and all that will go towards the symposium and the final report that will be presented at next year's Youth Assembly, leading up to the young people. So if anybody wants more information, then the trailer next week is the best place to come. But we are looking for new members, so we'll get all the information there as well.
Thank you. And now, the moment of the night that I've been looking for is lads.
Hey!
been done. It's already mostly filled out, so I shouldn't have much to do, and it'll be fine, and I'll get in, and it'll be great. Okay, I've already filled out personal details, and I put in my exam results, which weren't what I wanted, but were still pretty good. Final checks, and I think that's it. I think you can send it off. Maybe here I come, hopefully. Okay. Your application is not filled out properly. Please fill out every box that is required. I triple checked this. I could have sworn I filled out every important box. Wait. Gender and sexuality is required? Is it required field? What?
Right, okay. Opposite over adjacent is 16. Right. That one's right. For 9, that's right, okay. Almost 10 minutes left. I'm gonna be fine. Mum says I'll be fine, so I'm sure I'll be okay. 17. That's wrong. 6. That's wrong. 9. That's still wrong. Wrong!
Sophie, honey, are you okay? There's no need to get yourself into a tizzy about a silly exam.
Yeah, okay, Mum.
She doesn't understand that I've been through exams. I've done stressing out like her. Sure, when I did exams, it was a lot easier. But she has a supportive mum, unlike I did. All my mum did was pack a bag, and sometimes she didn't give up that right. If she passes, she's my girl. If she fails, she's still my girl. Right, Sophie, I'm away to work. I'll see you later.
Right, okay, Mum.
Alright, lesbo.
Back off, mate. I'm not a lesbian.
Go check yourself in the mirror. Dyke. Well, gotta clean them up.
How can you deal with bullies like that? I hate them. They're just out of order.
I don't know. Just ignore
them. I hate this as well. I'm only bullying them because I was bullied. A rubber, a bottle of water, a jotter just thrown at you, just for the sake of it.
I tell my purple hair teacher, my parents, but all they say is that I'm used to be a attention seeker.
They say they understand, but they don't. It's alright, just, like you said, keep our heads down, I'll grow my hair out. Don't worry.
I ever tell my passing care teacher, for anybody I could, all you told was, oh, they're just jealous of you, don't worry, you're better than them. How can someone so athletic like him be jealous of me? A wee fat guy.
If you'd like to enter the hall, your exam's about to begin.
See all these people here? They don't even pass. Unlike you. You're gonna fail. You're always gonna be a failure. You're going to fail. You're always going to fail. You're always going to fail.
You're going to fail! think, okay, this is the exam that you're good at, just to try and focus on the maths, not the fact that the table's wonky or I only have 3 tens instead of 4, but oh, should be fine. This is just a test that defines the rest of my life. If I don't get distracted by the gum under the desk, my hands aren't clean and I can't focus. I need to stop doing this. I don't need maths. What's the point of this? Some people in here might need maths, but not a lot of them. We're the kids that wanted to do art or drama, and they wouldn't let us do that outside of school, they said. But how can you? And the confidence that would have given you isn't there. And after this unnecessarily stressful exam, I'm going to have to go home and fill out an application that tells me that my sexuality defines whether or not I can get an education. Even if it gives me an advantage, that's not fair. It shouldn't matter, but apparently to them it does.
If you would like to put your pens and pencils down, your exam is now over.
Over half of these students in high school are bullied.
24% of people who were bullied become to be bullies.
You, have you ever stood by and watched someone being bullied?
So we wanted this event to show how much it can change your life, basically, and it, we did it, and we think it worked.
So, other than that reason, why else did we show? For fun. how does acting make you feel, and do you think it's good to keep motivated?
Well, I've been wanting to act since I was about 3 or 4 years old, and I had a friend that's mum ran an acting club, which is Class Acts, and my mum sent me, and I've been going there since I've been like maybe 4 or 5, and it just makes me feel happy, and I can like express every feeling, like happy or sad or depressed, and it just really helps you get your anger out.
You keep looking at me wanting me to answer something.
So,
we do like each other, just not that much. So far, lads are working on a panto, Cinderella, twin, Rebecca. But yeah, basically, it's really good because, shut up, Samantha. We're basically a community, even though I hate her, but it's like, we're just like, the wee cliche, we're like a wee family.
Wants to do like film
plays a big part in this.
So he wrote it for us, and he also directed it as well.
Yeah. We all like wrote little monologues of like what we find stressful about school and how we feel and like outside school and stuff like that. And we all kind of put it together in different pieces. Like one of us was like stressed in school. One of them was sexuality. One of them was like body image, and we all kind of put them together just as like this one big mental health piece. So it's like work small on us, and that's what makes it more special.
Self-harm and mental health. Well, so we're the nine.
Yeah.
I know. So, well, we have here Corby, who was involved in the film. So, just really quickly, if someone has any question, just if someone really has like a really burning question about the film.
What inspired
him? I think it was to begin with. Was it not for some sort of film festival to begin with? Yeah.
Yeah. For the Scottish Mental Health Arts Festival, and then we did a screenwriting workshop, and one of the young persons said that she went through self-harm and she wanted to raise awareness about the Butterfly Project, so that was how all it started. Yeah.
What do you want to achieve with this film other
than showing people like they don't have to self-harm and like going by websites and all that stuff? I think for the most part, this film is, it's not just about self-harm, as you're saying, but it's, I think we want people to connect with it, because I know for me there's like scenes in that where it's very real and the emotion and depth is there, and that's something that actually happens. Is not just, it's easy enough like when it's on screen or whatever, but it does actually happen. I think we want people to realize that it is a thing that's a real issue, and that it's not just a film scenario. Maybe, what, a little under a month?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We were in
a rush. Yeah, I remember spending a lot of time there, because as you, I was the guy with the long hair and the braces in that video. Actually, it's kind of a testament to how long it's been. It's a year and a half ago. But I was on both sides, and I remember going pretty much every day of the week, showing up.
During
the process of making it. And everyone who was there was absolutely fantastic, so it flew by like that.
Yes.
So what was your role?
Well, I was involved in pretty much almost every process, minus the editing, I think it was. I was involved in the camera work. I was behind the camera when I wasn't on screen. I was acting as Jack, one of Jack's, the guy who was acting the main character, Jaden. I was behind the camera when I wasn't playing it. Jack's best friend, Jack, ironically enough. And I was also involved with the screenwriting as well. Not as heavily as I would have liked to be, but yeah, I was involved. Any other questions?
Is Kate currently making any other future projects
as this? I'll give this over to Maria, since I have no idea.
Not right now. We have many other things happening, but no filmmaking right now. Great. I just want to rush because we are after time. So thank you very much for coming. What I want to say is like one of the aims of this event was to bring different people together and people from like different organizations and groups. And you know, like you all got amazing skills and maybe some skills that can complement each other. So you know, like we got dancers, we got actors, filmmakers and spoken poets. So, you know, it's just like, I hope this is like a starting point maybe for some people to start collaborating and to at least know there's someone else there who can maybe, you know, do some kind of project with them. So that would be great that after this event we see more of these things happening in between different organizations. Like, for example, if we make another film, we could lots of people and we can ask if they want to act on it. That would be great, you know, for example. Or when we do a music video, we can always go to the dance classes and say like, guys, would you like to dance for this? So we don't have to ask people in the street to dance as we did sometimes. So it's just like really for me a starting point as well. Like, we got some flyers and like some information. Guys, like for example, if someone saw like the dance group and they were like, well, we want to do that. You got here some information about the classes and stuff, and we're gonna be giving them while you go out, so just please take one and, you know, consider coming to our events. As we said, we have this event like next week that's You Matter Always, and what we want, like PESI 2021 ask us to bring young people together to talk about mental health and to kind of put like a bit of like, as the youth commissioner do it, we want the voice of the young people to be here. So this kind of event is what it allows the young people to have a voice and to go and talk what they want to see and what they want to change in the future. And we have as well, like next Tuesday, we have some writers' like event where, for example, Rachel and Brittany are going to be playing on. It's called Repertory Calling, and we have the flyers there. So just like take one on your way out. And thank you very much for coming tonight. Very nice.